Hello, this is a brief summary of an article written by Kirkwood and Price from 2013 entitled Technology Enhanced Learning and Teaching in Higher Education. It was published in the journal Learning, Media and Technology, volume 39, issue 1. My name is Kent. The focus in this article is the term technology enhanced learning in higher education. Now, this concept is abbreviated TEL, and the problem, according to Kirkwood and Price, is that this concept of TEL, it is only vaguely defined. Its exact meaning is not clear. So there's a need for more research on clarifying what this concept stands for. So it's not clear what is enhanced or how it is done. Neither is it clear how the enhancement is determined. In other words, what kind of proofs are put forward to verify that some sort of learning has actually taken place? In what way can we prove that technology-enhanced learning actually has some sort of effect? So, what Kirkwood and Price did was a literature review of 47 scientific articles with empirical studies. And they used the keywords technology, university, higher education, teaching learning, evidence, and empirical to browse through a couple of databases to find these scientific articles. And in the end, they found 47 articles in total. Now, what all these 47 articles had in common was that they reported some sort of results from interventions. In other words, the article authors intervened into regular courses and performed something. They did something. And what they all wanted was some sort of enhancement. They wanted to have some effect upon the students' learning or the teaching experience. And methods were also used to evaluate the effects of these interventions. And there were also different types of evidences used to prove or verify that the enhancement had actually taken place. Kirkwood and Price performed a so-called thematic analysis, and they had three specific questions in mind. What types of technology interventions were used in the articles? And how is this enhancement conceptualized by the article authors? In other words, how is the term enhancement defined? And what was used as evidence to demonstrate the achievements of these enhancements? In other words, how did they go about to actually prove that the intervention had some sort of effect? Now, according to the results, there are three types of interventions. Some articles are written where the authors replicate existing teaching practices. In other words, they focus on a course and they replace some sort of element within that course with a technical solution. They replicate what is already being done within the course. A second type of intervention is the so-called supplementary dimension. In other words, Kirkwood and Price found that some of the interventions were of the type where the authors supplemented existing teaching practices with new technologies. And finally, there were also interventions where the authors tried to transform or change existing teaching practices. Kirkwood and Price state that the intervention types 1 and 2 were aimed at doing things better, whereas the third intervention type were aimed at doing better things. Now let's pause here for a second. What do Kirkwood and Price mean? I want you to contemplate this. What does it mean to do things better or doing better things? Okay, moving on. They also showed that the enhancement is conceptualized in basically three different ways. It could be seen as an operational improvement. In other words, new technology is introduced to increase flexibility for the students or to improve student retention. Secondly, enhancement can be conceptualized as a quantitative change in terms of learning. In other words, improved engagement or time on task, or improved test scores. Thirdly, enhancement could also be seen as a qualitative change in learning. In other words, aiming for deeper learning or increased critical awareness. Kirkwood and Price also showed that there were many different forms of evidence collected by the article authors to demonstrate that enhancement had actually taken place. Interviews, questionnaires, student self-report surveys, etc., etc. You can pause the video and read the list if you want. Moving on, possible limitations. Well, Kirkwood and Price identifies a couple of potential problems. In general, it is rather difficult to attribute the enhancement solely to some sort of new technology. In other words, we don't always know what causes some sort of enhancement effect. Secondly, there were also problems with a limited and sometimes unreliable empirical data. They also mentioned that there were some limitations in terms of inconsistent reportings of definitions, methods, or results. In other words, these things weren't clearly described in the articles. So some of the descriptions left a lot to be desired. The ending remarks given by Kirkwood and Price can be summarized as follows. New technology can be used in multiple ways in higher education, and it can be adapted to different contexts, different courses. However, it's often used for reproducing and reinforcing already existing practices in higher education. In other words, university teachers, such as myself, introduces new technologies without a clear thought about in what way should these technologies be used to improve education. New technology is not enough per se to enhance teaching and learning. It is important to reconsider what teaching and learning actually means before implementing new technologies. And towards the end in their article, Kirkwood and Price speaks directly to future authors when they say that in future technology-enhanced learning intervention studies, authors should remember to clearly specify the methodologies and definitions. In other words, clearly stipulate what technology-enhanced learning means in your study. And also mention the limitations of your study and the generalizability of your findings. Wise words from Kirkwood and Price. Okay, that concludes the summary of the article. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.